Hello everyone and welcome back to Genie Crafts. In today's video, I'm going to attempt something that I've never done before. I'm trying to make a light box portrait, but rather than single color light box portrait, I'm trying to make a multicolor light box portrait. So first, let's see what are the different items that you are going to need to create this light box, and then we will go into the process of creation of this light box. So the first thing that you're going to need is a SVG template. In my lots of previous videos, I've already shown how to create this SVG template. You can click the link at the top or you can visit my channel and refer to those videos. So the total number of printouts that you are going to require is the number of colors that you want on your portrait light box. And it would be preferable if you could take a colored printout rather than a black and white printout. I took a black and white printout because I don't have colored printout facility at home right now. Next, you are going to need 300 GSM watercolor or canvas paper to create the layers. Then to assemble the pieces that we are going to cut out on those canvas sheets, we are going to need this acetate or OHP sheets. And finally, to bring the colored effect, we are going to need the colored trace paper. The color should correspond closely to the colors that are on your template. So to start the process, the first step is to create the cutouts for the respective color. So as you can see that I am affixing my template on my spare watercolor paper. The process is very simple. All you need to do is to ensure that you are only cutting out that particular color which you are working on. If I am working on the lightest shade, then I just need to cut out the pieces for that lightest shade. But I have to ensure that whatever cutout that I am getting should not contain any other color. If there is any other color, I just simply need to cut out and remove that. Also, every piece that you cut out for that particular color, keep it safe on the side because you are going to assemble that on the acetate sheet later on. And here we are with all the pieces for the first color, and now it's time to bring the actual color to it, which was the yellow color. So on the yellow trace paper, I'm going to stick these pieces. Ensure that you're sticking the back side of the pieces and not the front side of the pieces. And once we have stuck them, then we are going to cut around the border of the pieces so that our pieces are white from the front, but you know, colorful at the background. So when light hits from the back, the white sheet becomes, you know, that particular color. So in this case, it will glow as yellow color. And that's the reason why we are using white sheets and not any other color, because after you put trace paper at the back of a white sheet takes the color of that particular color trace paper. In a similar fashion, prepare rest of the pieces by putting, you know, yellow trace paper at the back of it. And once you are done with it, then we can proceed to the next step. Next step is assembling these pieces on top of an acetate layer so that you can complete your portrait layer for this particular color. So for that, take out the template using which you cut out the previous pieces. Ensure that you are not discarding the template paper for any of the layers, because you are going to use that to assemble and properly align all the pieces for the different colors and the different layers. So align the template layer properly over your acetate paper, and then clip the acetate paper and the template with the help of paper clips so that they remain in place, and then we can start sticking those pieces with the help of the cutout gaps that are already present on your template paper so that you can align those pieces correctly. For sticking the pieces and also for sticking the trace paper on the backside of the pieces, use a Fevis stick because it prevents warping or, you know, crumbling of the trace paper or the pieces, and your pieces don't look crumbled up. Alignment of the pieces with respect to the template is very important, because unlike other layered portraits, you are not going to build one layer on top of the other layers. All the layers are coexisting together like a jigsaw puzzle. Once you put all the layers together, they all are going to fit like the pieces of a jigsaw puzzle and show you a complete picture. Also, since there are colored trace papers at the back of the pieces, if these layers or if these pieces overlap, what is going to happen is that instead of showing the individual color of the pieces, they might show completely different color. For example, if I mix yellow and blue, I might see green color at the front rather than seeing either yellow or blue. So the alignment is extremely important and you have to take care of that. And this is how your different layers are going to look after you have finished assembling them on top of your acetate sheet. Similarly, assemble all the other colors on the acetate sheets, and then we will proceed towards assembly of the light box. I have completed rest of the layers of the camera, and here they are. If you will see that these are all different colored trace paper. So this one is blue, then I have a dark red one, then I have a light red one, and if you put them on top of each other together, they will form the picture of Messi, whose portrait I am making. Also, the sequence of the sheets is not important in this kind of portrait. Reason being, like I said before also, it's like pieces of a jigsaw puzzle. So no matter what sequence you put them in, finally they should show you the complete picture. And I was not able to completely align it because this was my first attempt. You can see that there are certain gaps that are forming at the boundaries of each layer, and this will reflect in the final output when I will switch on my light box. But more or less, I was able to achieve the alignment, and maybe in my next attempt I'll be able to do better. So after putting all these four colors together, all you can see right now is a white portrait, but when you will shed light on it, then you are going to see the actual colors. For light box, I am using the IKEA box frame, which comes with decent depth to cover my four layers. Also, there will be no gap between the layers to ensure that the difference at the boundaries do not come so pronounced. The light setup is already done. Click the card link at the top to see how you can do the light setup. I have explained it in one of my videos previously before. To assemble the layers in the light box, put them front side facing downwards, and once you have put all the layers, then put that inner frame that comes with this box frame. This will ensure that the layers are held in place. Unlike other light boxes, there is no gap between the layers to ensure that any difference in the alignment is not too much pronounced. Once you have put the inner frame, put a blank sheet of 300 GSM watercolor paper to dim the light a little bit, otherwise your light box is going to light up very bright because there is no paper as such. You have used acetate sheets. So put a sheet of A4 size paper and then cover it with your back cover on which the light setup is already assembled. Now after switching on the light, I could immediately see the most prominent flaw. I could see the LEDs at the back, which should not be the case. You should see soft light rather than actually being able to see the LEDs at the back of your frame. So to avoid that, what I did was that I also placed a white watercolor paper just below that inner frame, and I placed one paper after I put the inner frame, and then I covered it with the light setup. So that acted as a buffer, and I was able to dim the effect of the light a little bit and bring out the effect of colors more, like the images that you see right now. So as you can see that there is still a lot of scope of improvement, and couple of things right off the bat that I can say is that more proper alignment is needed. Instead of a yellow LED, I need a white LED to bring out the actual colors. I didn't have the white LED when I made this, but I'm definitely going to try this again with someone else's portrait, and hopefully it will be much better next time. So I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial on how to make a colorful lightbox portrait. And if you guys like the video, then please do not forget to hit the like button and share this video with your friends. And also do subscribe to my channel for regular videos on paper arts. And I will see you guys very soon in my next video. Till then, stay safe, take care, and bye bye.